looks like someone's trying to knock something off.
Deirdre, come on. Well, this is in your line of work, isn't it? What are you trying to do, Matt? Trying to take something out of the shop? Come on, we'll have to look at here. We'll have to get the sort of
detective
in here.
Looks like, we might be a bit of...
It's true. Fancy getting your kicks from going through all that dirty stuff.
Quiet.
Are you going to be much longer? I've got a few other calls to make this morning, you know.
No, we won't be long. I could make the time go faster for you, darling.
Me too.
I said keep quiet, and that means all of you.
Anything? All right. Come on, you lot, get this stuff into the laundry.
I know. How come they didn't find any of that stuff that we were supposed
to... Shut up, will you, or they will.
Yeah, it's a wonder they didn't find the you-know-what that I asked me old folks to smuggle in.
Daniels.
This is for you.
Come off it. What are you trying to do? Get me in trouble?
Oh, go on, please. Just for me.
Thank you. I'll take it. Surprised at you, Mackenzie. Think you'd get away with this stupid trick like... Oh, yes, yeah. That's really very funny, isn't it? Right, you get this laundry inside before I change my mind and put you on a charge.
It goes for everyone. Get moving.
Hey, I called Roxanne. She's going to be sending in some stuff real soon.
Good.
I have told you once.
Okay, Daniels, you can do the pickup from the laundry inside.
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
Hello, Driscoll House.
Erica Davidson, Judy.
Oh, hi, Mrs. Davidson. How are you? What can I do for you?
Well, actually, I was hoping you could do something for Lainey Dobson. I'm afraid she tried to get rid of her tattoos with caustic soda.
What? Oh, God, when did this happen?
Yesterday. She's just arrived back from the hospital. Apparently, she'll be all right, but I would like you to have a word with her.
Yes, of course. Listen, have you spoken to Mr. Douglas about the tattoo program?
Yes, I have, but unfortunately the cost is extremely high, and as you know, Lainey won't even be with us for much longer.
Do you mean to say they're not going to do it?
I'm afraid not.
Well, isn't that fantastic? And they give you all sorts of money for furniture and stuff like that, but when it comes to something worthwhile...
Judy, I'm sorry, but I did what I could.
Oh, it just makes me so damn mad, that's all. Sorry, Mrs. Davidson, can I come in and see you today?
Yes, of course.
Thanks very much. Bye. Those bastards.
Hey, what about that bit that's stuck on the van?
Yeah, didn't know which way to look, did he?
G'day, Maxine.
G'day, Lizzie.
I reckon you were all right.
Hey, lady, I thought you... What the bloody hell have you done to yourself? You look like you've been in a real blue.
Tried the caustic soda.
What? Oh, crikey, lady, that stuff eats into you like... Well, I guess you found that out. You're hurting real bad.
It's still there.
Hey?
It's still there.
I'm real sorry, mate.
Oh, Mrs. Powell, is it done? I'd like you to speak to the women for me, please. I'm rather tied up at the moment.
Yes, of course. What about?
I want you to tell them their mail will no longer be censored.
Oh, look, I'm sorry. Is that wise at the moment? We might pick up something about the dope that's being smuggled in.
Exactly.
Oh, I see. You think they may be less cautious if they think no one else is reading it?
Yes. One of them might drop something about the drugs or even the supplier. It's worth a try.
Yes, it's a good idea. I'll see to it straight away.
There is one more thing. I know it's not particularly pleasant, but I want all officers searched as they enter the prison.
Oh, that won't be popular.
I realise that, but there is still the possibility one of them may be involved. If so, I want her caught.
I reckon her burns must be real bad because she just sort of lay there and didn't say nothing.
Poor little bugger.
I wonder what mongrel gave her that rotten stuff.
Well, I don't know. I tried to talk her out of it when she asked me, but I never thought
all
she'd
right.
go and do...
You can stop work for a moment. Those of you who were working. You'll be pleased to know that the mail will no longer be censored.
Oh, Ripper!
How come, Mrs. Pear?
It's a restriction the department feels can be lifted. So that's their new policy.
Judy, I have already told you the department has turned it down.
Yeah, but that's because of the cost, isn't it?
Yes, mainly, but also because some of the methods have been rather disappointing. The women are left feeling worse off than they were before.
Yeah, okay, but look, I've heard of a new way of getting rid of tattoos. They've been using it at one of the girls' homes.
I see. What is involved?
It's good. What you do is you tattoo over the existing tattoo with bleach.
And it works?
Well, according to everything I've heard, it works really well. Best ever.
There's no scarring?
Well, there might be some little thing, but you can usually get rid of that with vitamin E cream.
Well, it sounds promising.
You're going to like the price, too. $130 for 100 tattoos.
Well, the department certainly can't complain about that. But don't get your hopes up too high. I'm not promising anything.
Well, I don't see how they can knock it back. I mean, it's the best rehabilitation scheme I've heard of.
Well, nothing so far. Mind you, all of these were written before their new censorship was off.
Before we lied to them, you mean?
If they didn't try and put it across us, it wouldn't be necessary, would it?
I suppose not.
I mean, what's going on around here? I just had my bag searched at the gate.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You'd left for lunch before I could tell you. It's a new regulation. All officers are to be searched on their way in.
Why?
Mrs. Davidson's orders. If it bothers you, I'd take it up with her.
Oh, it doesn't bother me. Of course, it won't affect those of us with nothing to hide, will it?
No, of course it won't.
I thought the women had been told their mail wouldn't be censored anymore.
Yeah, that's right, they were.
Helene, how you feeling?
I'll wait in the corridor.
Well, now what did you go and do a dumb thing like that for?
Well, what do you expect me to bloody well do after that interview? No one else had helped me. Now look at me. I'm scarred worse than before. No one gives a stuff about me.
That's not true, love. I care about you, and Alan cares.
He hasn't called for a long time.
Yeah, well, there's probably a very good reason for that. I'll tell you what. Why don't I go and see him? Find out what's going on.
What if he doesn't want to see me anymore?
Well, I'm sure that's not the case, but we'll never know until we try, huh? Lainey, please, give me his address, love.
Hurry up, you lot. You should all be outside by now.
Not you, Mackenzie. I want a word with you. It's about time we have a little chat about our partnership. I got the impression that that was over. Don't be stupid, Mackenzie. You couldn't exist without me, and you know it. Now, the governor's already making things a bit difficult for your little enterprise, but I've got a piece of information that you need.
Like what?
Payment first, $30.
You've got to be joking.
You've got a choice, Mackenzie. Pay up, or I take every cent you've got on you.
Good.
Now, this one's a real little gem. They're still censoring your mail.
Well, you've been told different.
They're just trying to con you, hoping you'll let something slip through about the drugs.
Bastards.
I thought you'd be interested.
Well, two can play at that game. Only I'll be one step ahead of them all the way.
Yeah, only if you've got someone like me with inside information. And don't you ever forget it.